मेरी पहली फिल्म है और बहुत लोगों ने इसमें ऑलरेडी मदद की है, आप में से कई लोग और मदद करने वाले हैं। इनमें आप में से कई ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने मुझसे बहुत ज़्यादा काम किया है, तो मुझे काम के बारे में तो कुछ कहना ही नहीं है, सिर्फ ये कहना है कि ये कहानी बहुत दिल से निकली है। डायरेक्टर बनने के लिए ये स्क्रिप्ट नहीं चूज़ हुई थी, ये स्क्रिप्ट जैसे कहते हैं ना कई बार स्क्रिप्ट आपको चूज़ करती है, तो ऐसे इस कहानी ने मुझे मतलब तकरीबन मजबूर कर दिया कि मैं एक फिल्म बनाऊँ।
आई हैव बीन इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द इशू ऑफ कम्युनलिज्म, एज इन व्हाट वी कॉल कम्युनलिज्म और सेक्टेरियन काइंड ऑफ वायलेंस, बट मोर इम्पॉर्टेंटली द वायलेंस दैट गोज ऑन इन द माइंड, यू नो, द प्रेजुडिसेस दैट वी इंक्रीज, द कंडीशनिंग दैट वी हैव हैड ऑफ इयर्स, द रोल ऑफ मीडिया इन इट, यू नो, कॉन्वर्सेशंस इन एवरी क्लास दैट ग्रेजुअली आर चेंजिंग, द फियर्स दैट आर डिवेलपिंग. And I was wondering how to sort of express it. It's more sort of almost like a cathartic thing.
All the very best to everybody. And hopefully, sab theek hoga.
Ravi K. Chandran, who is the cameraman, who is an old friend. I've done two films with him as an actress. So he was one of the first ones that I had contacted. I told him the story and it was still very vague. I gave him one of the early drafts to read. So he came on board, I think initially more as a friend.
Then she gave me the script. I was keeping the script for quite some time.
Okay.
I knew the story, but I didn't read it fully. Then I read it fully. And I really, one fine day I called her and said, like just one week before shooting, I called her and said, I really like the script. You know, it's not that I'm doing the film as a friend, I'm doing the film for the script also now.
So I started writing the script with a friend, Shuchi Kothari, who lives in New Zealand, who became a friend. In fact, I met her through a short film that I did there, and then she also felt strongly enough about the subject, and she teaches script writing, so I thought she was a good collaborator. So almost for 2 years we were working on it off and on, Skyping. I went to New Zealand, we wrote it there together, then we would do it long distance.
You must remember there's a time difference between New Zealand and India, so I would pretty much finish my whole day, and at night when it was afternoon in India, we would get on Skype, and then whatever we discuss, I would rewrite that night and then send it to her that night before I went to bed, which means when she woke up in India, she'd have it there for her to read, so that by the time we Skyped again at night, you know, she would have gone through it. So it was an absolutely crazy way to work. At the same time, you know, we really had a good time.
And I still didn't know when it was actually going to be shot, who's going to produce it, does it happen, nothing. It was really, you just do it because you feel strongly, and then you feel, okay, something will happen, the world will conspire. Nasiruddin Shah, Raghubir Yadav, Adipti Naval, these were some of the people that I had contacted even before I had a producer. And then slowly things started falling into place, and Percept Picture Company decided to take it up, and here I am. I can't believe it myself.
Action.
She had heard about PPC but didn't really knew whom to, how to go about and whom to meet and so on and so forth. So I kind of quickly called up my the MD of the company, Shailendra Singh, and he SMS back saying that yes, let's have a meeting tomorrow and you know, let's go ahead with the project. So that's how it happened. It all happened exactly within 5 minutes time.
I started meeting women ADs, and some of them I just anchored towards. So I think it's a good team of people, but there was no conscious effort to only take women. So my chief assistant AD is a fan, Vinod.
After reading the script and after few discussion and talks with Nandita, I knew that she has a philosophy, her own philosophy, which related to the Indian society, Indian community and the Indian religion. Like people need a thought after the film, not a feeling.
Baby catches.
When I started writing a story, it was actually only a one story. And then all these experiences of meeting so many people, you know, seeing it in different social strata, I felt a story wouldn't do justice to it. And that's why the ensemble structure emerged.
It is a multiple story film. And it basically deals with the interpersonal relationships that people experience in the backdrop of the riot scenario. In fact, the story is set 1 month after the riots.
Khasab and Kareem's story is a very special story in many ways. It's not a story where just things happen, but it's a story of two old men.
The relationship between Kareem and Khasab evokes Waiting for Godot to me. The play in which there are these two people who have been together since God knows when and will be together till God knows when. And they evoke a father-son, they evoke a husband-wife, they evoke lovers, they evoke friends, colleagues, enemies, anything that you can possibly imagine human beings to be to each other.
अस्तगफर अल्लाह चलिए उठे
एक हमारे बहुत पुराने अमीर खुसरो जो निजामुद्दीन औलिया के दीवाने थे वो उनकी रिलेशन इसी तरह थी वो पूरी तरह से डेडिकेटेड थे पूरा दीवान ही उनके वो बिल्कुल उनके सामने अपने आप को बड़ा छोटा समझते थे निजामुद्दीन औलिया के सामने ये अमीर खुसरो परेशान क्यों हो रहे हैं ज़्यादा लोग आ जाएंगे तो तीन को तोड़ के छः कर देंगे
इट वॉज फन टू बी दिस You know, nagging kind of couple at each other. They never shown even speaking affectionately to each other. But despite that, if the affection comes across, I think it'll be great.
एक्चुअली क्या ये किसी चीज़ की दीवानगी है यहाँ खान साहब क्यों म्यूज़िक का मैं म्यूज़िक का दीवाना हूँ जिस तरह खान साहब गाते हैं तो ये दीवानगी बात है इसलिए पूरी पूरी ज़िंदगी उन्होंने चाहे वो 40 साल हो 60 साल हो तो और भी 5-10 जिंदगियाँ और देना चाहता है अगर उस तरह का म्यूज़िक अगर उसकी ज़िंदगी के साथ जुड़ जाए तो
एंड देन आई हैव दिस वंडरफुल एक्टर हु आई हैव ऑलवेज एडमायर्ड रघुवीर यादव And I've always considered him to be one of the most gifted actors I have ever come across in my life. He'd be thoroughly embarrassed if I told him this, of course. It was no problem feeling the affection deep down because it is there. In his case, for me as well, because he likes me a great deal too.
बड़ा आराम से जिस तरह वो हैं वैसे मुझे महसूस हुआ तो मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा मेहनत अपनी तरफ से नहीं करनी पड़ी कि केमिस्ट्री बनाए रखने के लिए
This film, Nandita, has casted people appropriately. Now, for that casting, you need a touch of makeup, but it should be very subtle. But we are giving little touches to the character, like for Raghuveer ji, he is also Muslim, but he is little orthodox kind of and Muslim. So. He prays the namaz and all, so we have put some mark on his forehead.
I think back on my parents a lot of the time when I have to play parts like this. My mom was an orthodox Muslim, brought up in a very orthodox household, prayed 5 times a day all her life, fasted in Ramzan and everything, so was my dad. Ratna, my wife, is Hindu. I am Muslim. Neither of us felt the need to convert or even talk about it.
Okay, silence!
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 Lock set!
We are recreating a certain geography into another city Now, the place where we were shooting is Hyderabad, you know, and the old city of Hyderabad. It is said that it's very difficult to shoot in such areas because nobody has ever tried. But we went ahead with our conviction, feeling that, you know, if we are not going to do any harm to anyone, why should anyone do the same to us?
एक नजर डाली और निकल लिया।
कौन दो बुढ़ों को ले जाना चाहेगा?
अरे आपने तो ना देखने की ठान ली है। ओ मेरा बात सुताई नहीं चल रही।
She wanted, she was keen on doing the sing sound, but for me it was a little difficult, little tough, because on the real location, it's the kind of subject for this film is really needed a quiet location. Initially, I thought ki like I'll just call it off. I won't be able to do it. So then I thought ki like let's see, let's try it. My assistants and they wanted to. They initially they're not supposed to be job of for locking up the set, but they tried hard to make it possible.
I have to say she surprised me with her level of preparation and her precision of instructions. And I always felt that her instructions were helpful. I understood what she needed. We're also friends. I've known her for a very long time. And I'm extremely fond of her. But it really surprised me. Her understanding of what constitutes a performance on screen and her ability to get it from actors.
Over the last few years, we've become so aware of the religious identity that we have quickly divided ourselves and said, okay, I'm a Hindu, you're a Muslim, etc. You know, I'm a born Hindu. I mean, I don't practice any religion, but that aside, I am a Hindu is just one part of me. I'm also a woman, I'm also half Gujarati, I'm half Uriya. I'm born in India, I'm a non-vegetarian, I love music. You know, there are various identities to me. This is not an anti-Hindu film, it's not a pro-Muslim film. It's in fact not about religion. I think it's a pro-human film, at least that's how I see it.
A friend of mine who actually works for Percept Picture Company called me and told me, go and meet Nandita. So I said, Nandita for what? I mean, she's an actor. So he said, no, she's directing. So I said, oh, fantastic, that's really good. So I went and met Nandita and she came, she looked at me and she stood about 2 feet away from me. And then spontaneously, she just like sort of did a semi-hug.
We had a very casual meeting in Mumbai, in a suburban hotel. And she told me about this film and in particularly my story. I did say yes to the film without reading the script also, my story, because what she narrated when I read, it was pretty much the same. So my apprehensions were only the whether it works in totality, and more than that, whether my director wants to work with me or not, because you know, I could be wanting to work with her, but eventually she came back and nick of time, and she said, can you do the character?
Anu Sameer is a more sort of upper middle class, our kind of people who talk a lot. And it's a story of a Hindu-Muslim mixed marriage couple.
Oh, come on! People have been raped, killed, burnt alive for no fault of theirs. Anu, there are always two sides to a coin. If those people hadn't started this violence, things would not have been this bad. No offense, Sameer. I can't believe you're justifying this madness. तू मने के जारी तारी मेर तारी जुड़ी लाइनी भागी गई थी you didn't go and touch the whole Chhara community, did you?
Just to go away a little from the film, my background is from, I was born and brought up in Kashmir, and we were in minority over there. I had to grow a beard to be able to take my exams. I had to look like, I had to wear Islam on myself as a religion to be able to move around freely in the valley. And in real life, I was a Hindu guy trying to, you know, be accepted. And just lead a normal life. So all I had to do was think reverse, and now I'm a Muslim guy and a similar thing was happening.
Please don't do this.
As far as Anu goes, I think that she is genuinely in love with this man. And for her, his religion is a non-issue, was a non-issue. But now for some reason it's being sort of shoved in their faces and they don't really know how to cope with this. And she's seeing this person who's troubled, and his trouble is her trouble. She's really upset. She's upset about him being upset, plus she's upset that she is having to leave the city that she so loved for so long, grown up in.
Action.
At one level, if you look at Sameer's story, he could come across as a very indecisive, schizophrenic kind of guy, you know. At one moment, he decides that he wants to be himself. The other moment, his fears are haunting him.
Because you have no balls, okay? Put the Ameri.
It's always difficult to say, you know, things like these, that I'm a coward and I'm scared. I cry, I have no balls, firstly, it's a man thing.
We see a fairly vulnerable side of men in the film, and I think we also see quite a vicious side as well, I'd say.
As a woman director, there are certain things, whether it's in performances, whether it's in your writing, whether it's in your crew and all of that, that are subconsciously, I guess you see it from a woman's point of view, or you anchor towards certain things.
And then given who we are as people, you can't help but privilege the strong female gaze.
What I feel one of the strengths of women is that they paint with a very fine brush. When she's looking at the monitor, she's sort of checking to see, that's not right, this is not right, and she'll catch little things in your performance. The minuscule nuances of a performance are, I'm finding that she's concentrating a lot on that and getting that out.
And she has a good body of work herself, so she cannot be making something which is, which is nonsense. So I appreciate her as an actress, and she'll make something sensible.
When they think you are this thinking actress doing serious cinema, they think you're going to make a good film. I think the expectations in some ways from me are greater than, you know, what I can probably even deliver. I mean, who knows? My life has been more about the journey and less about the destination. And in fact, this is the first time I feel that there is much more pressure, there's much more weightage on the outcome, you know, as opposed to the journey. And I want to be able to live every minute of the journey, as opposed to constantly think of the outcome. But here you have to. You have canned it, you have shot it. There is a lot of money involved. There are 60 people and their lives and their faith in you involved. So you have to be literally on your toes every minute.
Hey, guys, please, come on. You're leaving tomorrow, no? And can we change the topic, please?
And in any case, we too have had our own share of loss.
A loss that's covered by insurance. Chalo. We've got tons to do.
Whether we like it or not, we all have a certain prejudice in our minds. May not be about religious orientation, but maybe about, you know, fair, dark, thin, fat, rich, poor, English speaking, not English speaking. This way of putting labels on people makes us comfortable because we need to slot things to become comfortable ourselves. I think somewhere that for me, this character is an opportunity to let go of my own prejudices.
I had to keep on, location hunting, simultaneously, you know, while the shoot was going on, I had to keep on, you know. And then also it's a question of then meeting so many people, so many authorities and, you know, religious leaders and so on and so forth. So it's not just one single window stop where you go and, you know, put in an application and they say, yes, fine, you pay the monies and it's done. Apart from permissions, there are layers of what you call getting people's support on your side. It's about convincing them, it's about requesting them, it's about coaxing them to kind of help us to finish our work on hand.
Sir, sir, की भी फोटो ले रहे हैं ना, अली भाई?
अरे हमारे कौन लेंगे भाई?
We had an entire unit placed at the Kabristan at about 4 o'clock. But when they saw, you know, 15 vehicles walking in and, you know, trucks rolling in and, you know, about 100 odd people all over the place, I think they got a little taken aback by this entire magnitude and size. That's when the authorities came and said that you stop this. And production, hence production and the shooting of that particular scene was stopped.
I was hiding and then suddenly the cops came back and said they wanted to seize all the trucks, all the buses. And as the bus was driving to the police station, Bablu sort of slowed the bus down for a second and I jumped off the bus. And then I ran in the opposite direction so the cops wouldn't see me. And I think then these guys didn't come back until very late at night. But everybody was back on shoot the next day.
Sometimes it's beyond you. You almost feel that you play a very small part in it, literally. There are 100 other logistical production things that you don't think have anything to do with creative process. And the whole struggle is to keep your creative instincts alive, you know, when you're actually shooting.
हनीफ एक नॉर्मल सा एक ऑर्डिनरी बंदा है जो रोज़ कमाते हैं खाते हैं, अगर रोज़ ना कमाएं तो खा भी नहीं पाएंगे वो। तो क्या होता है कि अगर 3-4 दिन उनका कुछ काम ना करें तो बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगी, लेकिन ऐसे में 1 महीना उनको रुकना पड़ता है तो कैसे खाएंगे कमाएंगे, बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम हो जाती है।
तो हाथ में कैसे ठोगा अभी? इनको फॉलो जो करेंगे आप लोग कैसे चलेगा ना?
रिक्शा पुलर वर्किंग क्लास कपल and they again sort of bifurcate, they come back to see a, you know, their house completely burned down and how the woman sort of is trying to rebuild life and how this man wants to take revenge but doesn't know how to because he's not a violent man.
House burning down, which was probably their own property, was all their asset and everything. I guess in terms of playing it out, one always connected to how you as an individual would react, as a personal being would react to something like this. And I think it was very well written. It was perfectly written and there was it was all there in front of me.
कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें थी जो मुनीरा को पसंद थी उस घर में, कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें थी जो हनीफ को पसंद थी उस घर में, वो सब कुछ खत्म हो गया। तो अभी तो इस टेंशन में हनीफ उसको दो चार थप्पड़ भी मार देते, लेकिन इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि उनका रिलेशन खत्म हो जाएगा।
वाले
थे। वो सोप था
ना, तो मैं सोपे पे बैठने का। अब कट कट नवाज़ पॉकेट में रखने का बहुत अच्छा। इन अ मैरिज ऑफ दैट क्लास, दे आर नॉट नेसेसरली ऑलवेज वेरी क्लोज एंड आई थिंक दिस ब्रिंग देम क्लोजर देन दे एक्चुअली आर। सो कॉन्वर्सेशंस आल्सो एंड द ब्लेम गेम एंड things, they were all ways of probably bringing them closer together in a sense.
घर बोला था ना दूसरा ताला लगवा देने को,
तो मेरा बाप है ये।
शाहना और मैंने, हम दोनों ने ऑडिशन दिया था इसका, तो उनका जो इंटेंसिटी है, उनका जो काम करने का तरीका, उससे मुझे पता चला कि वो किस तरह का काम करती हैं। तो ऐसे नहीं कि हमने बहुत एक दो सीन किए थे, उससे पता चल जाता है ट्यूनिंग हो जाती है उसमें।
इन अ वे बिकॉज इट वाज अ स्टोरी व्हिच वाज अबाउट you know, the internal side of the character, it was easy to place yourself in that position just as you are. You didn't have to become a Mehndi Wali or have to know what a Mehndi Wali is like.
My character's name is Jyoti and my best friend's name is Munira. And I think that Jyoti just likes Munira as a friend. She doesn't consider whether she's Hindu or she's Muslim or she's whoever she is like. She likes her as Munira, you know, and she happens to be a Muslim, you know. So even if all those things have happened, the riots and all those things have happened, it never occurs to her that now Munira is a Muslim and now I should get distance from her. As far as Shahana is concerned, I met her only once before coming here for shoot, you know. And then, but something, many things matched, you know. And then we didn't know it, but dheere se we realized that, oh, you do this, I also do this. You do this, I also do this.
तब हम बोलेंगे अच्छा। और ये बिंदी बिंदी का भी वो ऊपर आते वक्त या कुछ दरवाजे पे या कुछ
ठीक है
When we met the first time to do our lines, we really hit it off and we started talking. So there was an element of getting along that began before the film started. And then even when we came into Hyderabad, we traveled together. So we became very familiar with each other very soon. And I think that that must have added something to the way we were playing things out.
I would like to have that quality of Jyoti, you know. That once you love a person, you take that person with all his tantrums, moods, whatever it is, you know, and then you go beyond his, whatever he's attacking you or whatever he's doing. You go beyond all that and you love that person from the bottom of your heart. That loving and forgiving quality which Jyoti has, I think I've got that from this film.
First of all, it's exploring a social event or a catastrophe through relationships, through changes in relationships, as opposed to an external change. And I think that's a more... yes, that's our DOP.
I never consider my work as a very serious issue. I work by instinct. Sometimes my wife used to say, you're a fluke. I don't think you know anything about filmmaking, you're just shooting. So I think I enjoy my shooting. Enjoy the shooting time. So this keeps me moving. So whenever I shoot, take a good shot or anything, get a good visual, you get excited. And when you get frustrated also, you make fun of it and make the situation lighter. After all, it's a movie. We thought we'll shoot each episode with different stock and try different style of mostly one particular lens I used in one character, like followed one character. Some one character I shot in handle, one character I shot in dollies, one character I'm shooting in statics.
Rolling! Party one by one take.
Pani!
Yeah. Hello!
And the lighting style is mostly realistic and to a point we didn't use most of the time lights, we try to use natural light and shoot it, so it's like we did various tests about this stock preferences and how the stock react to certain levels, so we were pretty much sure what we are going to get. So we all learning like students, so it's like I'm also learning, they are also learning. So we, I have a little more experience, they don't have. So sometimes they will come up with new ideas, so we incorporate and see. Sometimes I see their point of view. So there are a lot of young mind work in it. So we treat everybody not like assistant, but we still, you know, it's like your kids, you, when you want to set them right, you give them one slap and set them right. It's like that.
Blue.
Very, very specific.
No, no, it's green. Cameraman is colorblind. I don't know what's going to happen to this film.
Yeah. That's
why. I mean, Ravi has contributed a huge amount to the, you know, the whole visual language of the film and all of that.
बाकी करने से पहले नंदिता ने काफ़ी हमें हम सबको काफ़ी समझाया कैरेक्टर के बारे में, वहाँ के बारे में, एटमॉस्फेयर के बारे में, अहमदाबाद का किस तरह के लोग होते हैं, अहमदाबाद में ऑटो ड्राइवर, ये किस तरह की लैंग्वेज है, एक्सेंट है, ये सारा बताया. नंदी गुप्ता जो डायरेक्टर है वो एक्टर की डायरेक्टर है, वो एक्टर उनके साथ बहुत कम्फर्टेबल फील करते हैं क्योंकि वो खुद एक एक्ट्रेस है, बहुत अच्छी एक्ट्रेस है.
She's not been just a director. Even on set, she's always Nandita. She's a person who you can talk to about anything, you can joke about stuff, and you can ask about work. And she looks into every matter, and she's really held everything together in a very calm and casual way, which has probably eased everyone else out as well.
Art Dhanuman. Hey, तू तो पुल पार था ने, इसलिए ऐसा सोच भी सकता है. पर क्या अपने को मन नहीं करता सालों को खत्म करने का?
चलने पे कर डालते हैं ना, चलने भी.
किस किस को मारेगा तू?
हैं? किस किस को मारेगा तू?
सबसे पहले मेहुल को.
मेहुल?
उसको बताता हूँ मैं कैसे होता राग के ढेर में जलना है. कीमा नमा नमा.
देखिए फिल्म में तो इसमें तो इतना मुझे इतना नहीं बताया गया कि कैसे मिलिटेंट बनते हैं, लेकिन इतना ज़रूर है कि जब आदमी पर पड़ती है तो वो उस वक्त पे कुछ सोच नहीं पाता और वो उस गुस्से में पता नहीं क्या 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 कर जाता है, कुछ पता नहीं चलता. जो समझदार होते हैं वो इस तरह का कदम नहीं उठाते.
लाइक लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स पीपल थिंक ऑल यंग मुस्लिम मैन आर रेडी टू गो फॉर जिहाद. But there are a lot of young Muslim men who have no idea what to do with their lives, what to do with all this prejudice, what to do with all this even anger.
We had to have this quiet crossroad with not a soul, dead of the night. And we reached the location 2 hours before the shooting and there are only 10,000 people. My cinematographer, Ravi K. Chandran, completely panicked and other people did so. And so I took the mic, went into the center. So I sort of said, I said, look, here is a film. This is my first film that I'm doing. Everyone told me not to shoot in old Hyderabad city, that it's going to be very difficult. And with your help and with the confidence that we are going to shoot here, we will shoot here, but I need your help. And I gave this sort of long emotional speech that truly came from the heart. And it was to everyone's surprise, to some extent, even to my surprise, that people just completely quieted.
Action.
I felt really good. I'm not saying all the credit comes to me, to all of those people who also helped in doing crowd control.
Emergency burn aisa hoga.
ठीक है मुझे बर्न का कोई एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है. नहीं पर मैं ये कह रही हूँ, ये ठीक है. ये थोड़ा और डार्क रेड कम रेड कम.
आई लाइक द आइडिया दैट यू नो आई एम गोइंग टू क्रिएट एन इमेज. या एंड सो एक्चुअली द लेंथ ऑफ इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट. इन दैट वन फ्रेम आई हैव टू यू नो ब्रिंग बैक ऑल दोज यू नो व्हाट आई हैव बीन थ्रू. And which will be very, you know, I think it'll have an impact.
Lot of good and good scope of prosthetic makeup is there. Technically, for makeup for each and every department, this film is, I mean costume also, this film is a tougher film.
I have lived in Ahmedabad for 3 years, but I revisited the city to see the people
from a costume designer's point of view. And I went to visit all the areas which were affected by riots. I saw people, I generally spoke to them about how they are and what is it, why are they wearing this. And we have picked up a lot of new clothes and then aged them. And we have done a lot of aging and small details, how clothes will tear and wear more. So my team has done a lot of work. I think that's what makes a difference between other work and this work, is like people should be part of the story, not the individual personality should come out.
Prakash Jha was making a film in Rajasthan. So I thought Jatin's daughter, I was told, is playing one little small role in the end. And I saw her, she was so young and she was really lovely and beautiful to look at, of course, you know. And from that time I was reminding her, I said, remember when I saw you first?
मेरा नाम मोहन है, मोहसिन है।
रसोड़े में मोहसिन और बाहर मोहन है नहीं?
मेरे को कैंप वापस नहीं जाना।
तू मोहन बन के यहाँ रहेगा?
पहले मेरे अब्बू को खोजने चलोगे? आपको भी जलाया?
She's just trapped within this role that she has to play in her household as a wife, as a daughter-in-law, as a mother. But she's really somebody who thinks a lot about what's going on outside.
Coming.
See, regardless of my being busy, there is a kind of a drive in every actor, I believe, to do good work. Good, meaningful cinema. And regardless of what you get paid for the mainstream commercial cinema. But then there is kind of a drive to stand by a filmmaker who has a passion to make good films. And you really feel nice and happy and satisfied when you become a part of that particular cinema. It so happened that because my comedy films have been hugely successful, so as it goes in our industry, you are just bombarded with the same kind of roles. And when somebody comes up with a different role, I'm ready to grab it.
જો આપણને ખબર હોત કે પોલીસ સ્ટેશનમાં પહેલેથી રિપોર્ટ ફાઇલ થઈ ગયો છે તો ત્યાં તો ચૂતિયા ના બન્યા હોત.
પણ મને બારોટે કહ્યું હતું.
માય યો બારોટ હમણાં એ ડીસીપી છે ને એ સાલો બકરા ગોતે છે. તારા જેવા એક બેને પકડીને રાખી દેશે અંદર અને બાકીના બધા છૂટતા.
મને બધાનું નામ ખબર છે ભાઈ.
હે ભગવાન, આમાં ડોબા વિટનેસ ન થવાય, સમજો? આ રેપની સજા છે, 7 વર્ષ માટે અંદર ખાલી દેશે.
Hindus are in majority and all this. Still, they feel oppressed in India. Can you ever imagine a majority feeling oppressed? Because by the simple virtue of, because they are in majority. So whatever you do will be looked down as a kind of a communal or kind of a, some kind of a bias. And it's not, so all these things are there going on in this character's mind.
Making
a woman point of view to see these whole things, you know, it's very, very interesting.
Action.
ये पाठू मिठू बोली है, मिठू लाओ.
Sanjay's character is this typical middle class man who is not only a symbol of patriarchy, so communal in his own way. Maybe he doesn't even perceive himself as that.
No, this boy is very, very, very good, you know. He's like, he keeps smiling on the set when he has to do these serious scenes, and this amazing smile that he has, which keeps coming back on his face, and Nandita has to keep saying, you're not to smile, you're very serious, you're going through this, you've come from here, you know, so all the time we have to deal with that. He's lovely, he's quite a sweet performer. It was just, we just blended in from scene one.
I think in Samad,
you know, really, I feel like I've found a gem. Because even in today's children, often, especially in big cities, you don't find that level of childlikeness, that genuine innocence. And he is not only innocent, he's extremely smart. He's, because it's also a technical medium, you have to tell him to come to a mark, you have to take the lie, there are lots of technicalities. And he's so quick at taking instructions. He has understood Mohsin. His face almost changes when I say, you're Mohsin right now, you're not Samad. So Mohsin's character is really the process of losing that innocence because of the things he sees and watches and hears, that gradually he's being forced to become an adult. He's saying things, he's suddenly growing up too fast, and that is such a pity. Like 10 days before the shoot, and I was in Hyderabad, I went to many different schools. And in fact, even after finding him, I was still looking at other schools because he was smiling so much and he had such a lovely smile. I thought, oh, I don't know whether he's going to be able to be serious. And then I just kept coming, his face kept coming back to me. And so it was in just randomly, like one of the Hyderabad schools in the old city, that I found him. Hiding literally behind a table, and I said, okay, where's that child?
वे भागे बंडी के नीचे छिप गए कट हो गया अटैच
फॉर मी अ डायरेक्टर इज डिफाइंड बाय द सब्जेक्ट ही और शी चूजेस एंड टू चूज दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट आई थिंक शी इज हियर टू स्टे
फोन प्लीज हियर
एंड शी गिव लॉट ऑफ स्कोप टू द एक्टर्स आल्सो नेवर काइंड ऑफ यू नो यू डोंट फील केजी और काइंड ऑफ यू नो इज इट टाइड अप एंड ऑल दैट free, and at the same time, she is so sure-footed.
So on action, she has opened the door.
She knows what she wants to do, and she keeps going at it till she gets it. And I like that. She's a delight, I think, for actors. Because she's an actress, you know, she knows what she wants, how it can be done.
I think when you can step back and look at a performance, you can judge it better. And I'm suddenly getting this opportunity to look at all these wonderful actors and step back and see what else one could do. And it's a process that evolves together. You know, sometimes I say, why don't we add this? What do you think of this? So we've been working together pretty much with all the actors. I've had a great time, in fact, working with the actors. And it's been a challenge. It's been a challenge that I think found very interesting. There are a lot of learnings, not just about cinema, but about people's psyche, about human relationships, about powers and hierarchy, and whole lot of other things that I probably wouldn't have learned.
You're seeing bigger here. No,
they are here, you are saying.
When they come out, they've
gotten out. No, that you are saying now.
To make her understand cinematically, also convincingly, it takes time, so we keep fighting about it. So the fights always happen over that. You know, she always thinks in a story wise.
See, when there are different people, different creative minds, there are bound to be certain differences of opinion. There are bound to be different ways of looking at things. Any form of art, in any case, is subjective. There is nothing right and wrong. You know, there are just different ways of rights, you know. So we have had a couple of sort of squabbles about something or arguments about something.
It's not personal fight, it's about to tell a story. That always happens. And there's no resolution. Like, you know, she knows that's how I work and that's how she works. So we laugh at it in the evening.
It's like a marriage and it's like a family where you have, you know, good times, bad times, all kinds of times. I think people are mature enough within the team to kind of not to make that an issue, and you know, rather than doing that, just get on with life and, you know, with the task ahead.
Regardless of what had happened the day before, everyone would be smiling and say, good morning, good morning, and really lovely group.
There were no grudges or no carry forwards of the, you know, previous day. It was nice.
I'm looking forward to the post as well, and I think a film really gets made again, all over again in post.
And I was really fortunate to have, I think, the best partner in crime, Shrikar Prasad, who is not only a very experienced and a really good editor, but also a lovely person, because that really helps. You're spending so many hours together and, you know, you have to be on the same wavelength. You have to have similar sensibilities. So for me, editing was the most exciting process, and I kept going back to it many times. I would almost think it's all done. Shrikar Prasad would often tell me that, so are you sure it's final? And I would say yes, and he would say, I don't believe you, because I know you're going to come back with your 10 points again tomorrow. And I would go back to Delhi and, you know, come back here, look at it again, come back to him after a week or so and with my little points.
When I saw the film first time, and that time I was totally stunned with the impact of the film, and something was growing in terms of the tonal feel.
When I did my short film, first film in fact, a 90-second public service ad, that's when I tried to get Jhukku, Rajat Dholakia, and he was too busy and he couldn't come. And I think since then I had a hangover.
Lots of Persian instruments are there. Oud is there. Then different type of flutes. We have used piccolo also. We have used the Indian classical high
pan
flutes.
Flute.
Then we have used pan flute. And
Chinese,
we have used the Chinese flute also.
I used to always think that no keyboards. I want real instruments where I can actually hear each instrument, and yet they sort of float in and they just form a layer in the soundscape that Manas Chaudhary and his team had done in terms of sound.
Wherever it was sounding some sugary sweet music, because that scale is very dangerous scale.
We got rid of it immediately.
Very dangerous scale.
Whether it's the cinematography, it's the performance, it's the art direction, it's the direction, it's the music, nothing that takes away from the journey of the characters. Finally, you as an audience want to just see these people and what they are going through.
The director, she has guided us to really do the best for her film.
So we had a great time, worked on it, but the ad world took the better of him after 4 days, and he couldn't give me too much time. And then I needed to get someone else, because unfortunately the timings just didn't match, and that's where Piyush Kanojia came on board. He had also worked with Rajat Dholakia, so they were completely comfortable working with each other. And that's where these two sort of did some magic, and people have loved the music.
नंदी चाची ये बोलती है साउंड स्ट्रोलिंग कैमरा स्टैंड बाय एक्शन.
You know, from the cameraman to the spot boy, everyone has been just so supportive, so wonderful. And I think when good people surround you, there is a different energy that gives you a different level of, you know, passion, a different level of commitment, and you enjoy your work then.
And we like
the hero. Apna bhi kaam nikalo. बेताब सा है सीने में आतिश बहर दिल गुजरात के फिराक सुन.